अंदर की नमस्कार नेनु तेलुगु नेर्चुकुंटुन्नानु मीरु चेप्पिनदि नाकु अर्थमैंदि ई एम रियली वेरी हैप्पी टू इंट्रोड्यूस दि वन इयर बुक टू यू बट एज इट इज सेड ई ऑलवेज ऐ एम डॉटर ऑफ तमिलनाडु बट ऐ एम सिस्टर ऑफ तेलंगाना सो फॉर द बर्थ प्लेस बिकॉज ऐ वेंट देयर अमंग द मीडिया पीपल ऐ डोंट डिफरेंशिएट वेदर इट इज तेलंगाना आर तमिलनाडु For me, all media friends are friends because they are very much supportive to me, not only during my political career, but also during my career as tenure as governor. Really, they are very supportive to me. So, first of all, I thank them. And as it is said, first of all, as when I took the charge as the governor, there was some critical comments were there. She was a president of a particular party, and then she has come here. She's the youngest governor, and whether she'll be able to manage this youngest state. I always say, and I said the first day, Telangana is the youngest state, and I am the youngest governor, and I am a gynecologist. So I'm experienced in handling the newborn babies. So I will be definitely do good to this newborn baby and care the newborn baby so that it is grown to its full strength with good nutrition. And till now, I am, to my mental satisfaction, I'm doing it. That's all I can, first of all, convey to each and everyone. And as it is said, I am always a people friendly person, and I, as it is said, tea for Tamil Nadu, for Telangana, for Tamilisai. And there is another very good coincidence with my life and Telangana. Actually, my husband Dr. Soundarajan is called as PSR, and Tamilisai Soundarajan is called TSR. So that is the name of our Telangana state. And my birthday and Telangana's birthday the same day, June 2nd. June 2nd is my birthday. So definitely there is a coincidence, a destiny between Tamil Nadu and Telangana and Tamilisai. And when I came here, really I love the people of Telangana. I like the tradition of Telangana. I love the pattern of life of Telangana because we are all sisters. We were all once together. Linguistically, then lingually we were separated, but traditionally we were all together. So I always have a very cordial relationship approach with the people of Telangana, and I want to do something to the people of Telangana. As it is said, as if the governor post is not a resting period, it is an experience for the rest of the life, I can say. And Telangana, when I landed here, it was a period of that time, dengue fever was prevalent at that time. As it is said, most of them, what is the relationship between the government and the governor? I clearly understand what is the responsibility of an elected government and what is the responsibility of a governor and what is the responsibility of the post which we are holding and what are the boundaries of that, what are the limitations of that, what are the powers of it. So I clearly understand that, and I want only the people to get benefited. So one of the media person only asked me, what is your relationship with the chief minister? I told it's only issue based, not fighting, not fondling. That was my answer. So as a governor, because I always have represented my opinion views to the government, and the government has taken it in a very positive way, particularly during my initial appeal was during the dengue fever. As a doctor, as a person attending the pediatric cases, I wrote a letter to the government saying that the dengue should be controlled in such a way. So I 15 points I conveyed to the government. First, there was little hesitancy. But after that, they took it and it in a very positive way. Like that, even during the pandemic period. Pandemic period, first, we all know that the state was low in testing. Some certain restrictions were there. But as a doctor, very strongly, in a very concrete way, I put forth my views. So these all should be done to curtail the pandemic. And the government responded positively. The way how you convey and the way how it is accepted, that is the way the government and the governor relationship. Everything for the people. Usually I don't compromise on things which will affect the people. Here it is said that most senior person told that some problem there in the educational system, the universities. From the first day, we are addressing it. And during the pandemic period, no day was wasted. Each and every day, we had video conference with the universities. And I compiled totally about the four. This is the horoscope of Telangana 14 universities. How many vacancies are there? How many posts are there? And what's the fate of the vice chancellors? And how many vice chancellors to be appointed? Everything, each and everything we compiled. We had a very exhaustive and elaborate interaction with the university staff, university registrars, the academicians, the non-academic staff. So single day, whole day we interacted with one university. And then I compiled everything and I gave to the government. Now the government is responding. So why I am telling, whatever may be the issues, I always think about the people and it is for the people. I don't say that government is not thinking. Government is an elected government and definitely all the governments, not only this state government, all the state governments have the responsibility to safeguard their people. But whether I am a problem solver or I am a catalyst, I am a facilitator. I can facilitate things. And as it is said, as a doctor, when I was practicing, people will be attending my clinic, even though I was a political leader, for some time I was practicing. People will be sitting in my room, in my reception. Only when, whether I am treating or not, I will hear the problem. So that hearing the problem itself will solve the disease 50%. So that only I am here doing. I want to hear whatever the, whether it could be solved, whether it could be just passed to the government, whether it is, could be followed up. There is one person to hear the problem of the people. Sometimes it could be solved very easily. Sometimes it could be conveyed to the government and sometimes it could be delayed. But there is a person in Raj Bhavan to help the people, to facilitate the, convey the message from the people to the government. And I want to be a bridge between the people and the government and a bridge between the central government and the state government. So this is a bridge. And always I want to help the people. I want always sector very nearer to my heart. Particularly when I meet the Honorable Chief Minister, I always say, the government hospitals should be improved. That is the final hope for the poorest of the poor. And I am gained my undergraduation from a government medical college. And I was working as an assistant professor in a private medical college. So I know how the people are benefited, the poorest and poor are benefited by the government hospitals. So I always convey, I get the information from other states. For example, in Tamil Nadu, government hospitals, pay and use wards are there. Just for 100 rupees, they can get a ward, private room with privacy. So I was conveying this to the Honorable Chief Minister when I met him. So he told, okay, we will develop. So whatever may be the good things I hear from other states, particularly because I am from Tamil Nadu, when such things are, even during pandemic, we could exchange our views. When the Hyderabad was suffering with from floods. I called a honorable chief minister from Tamil Nadu so he could help, give some help to the people of Telangana. So he announced 10 crores immediately. So then followed by other chief ministers. So whatever may be the smallest thing which could be done for the people of Telangana, I am eager to do, I want to do, and I know what is the post of governor also. How the governor can implement things and what are the powers of governor, whether he can independently do anything, okay. But whatever may be the post we hold, we are for the people, and I want to do, I want to concentrate on certain things. And I want to, here we have introduced the e-office, public redressal system, where whatever may the request we receive, then we see it, whether to which department it can be referred, whether we could solve the problem, and every day we are following it. It's not just like a post box. It's definitely, it is considered humanitarian grounds, and it is considered patiently, and what, wherever it could be referred, we are doing it and we are following it. And other, the focus which I want to be more particular is the tribal welfare. I have a very good plan for the tribals. I am following them post-pandemic period, how their nutritional status is there, how their livelihood is. So I have a plan to travel in the post-pandemic period. We are unable to travel, but I have planned a long tour to the tribal areas, and I have some plan to feed them, to educate them. So a concrete plan I have developed. And the nearby school is the Raj Bhavan school. When I went for a program, one of the teacher and the headmistress told, most of the children are coming without breakfast. So we thought, because I cannot manage all the schools, but I can, to a smaller extent, I can manage the school which is nearer to Raj Bhavan, the Raj Bhavan school. So we are providing like breakfast to the children. The initiation is named as the Raj Bhavan Annam. And we are going to extend even to the others, even our gardeners, our economically poorer section of our staff also taking the food from Raj Bhavan Annam. The same type of food provision is I am planning to give to the tribal people also. So these are the plan which I have. And whatever may be the period which I am occupy, I am here, definitely it will be for the people. So most of them were telling, I wish a long tenure for you here. I think there's some meaning in that, because I am from a political background, and I was holding a post of a state president for more than 5.5 years. So most of them, most of our seniors are blessing me like that. Whatever maybe I take, whatever things, it's, I think it's a blessing. Whatever the work given to me today, I will do. I won't bother about tomorrow. So I always say, in Tamil we say, Andavanum Andukondirupavanum, which means God and the ruler. Duty which is given to me, I will do to my perfection. I am really very happy because today women empowerment is gaining in Telangana. I am really very happy on that. When I was introduced and when I acquired the power of as a governor, there were no even women ministers. The first, after I came only, morning I took oath and evening I gave oath to two women ministers. But now, in the recent development of GHMC, women empowerment has acquired a very important position. As a woman, I am very happy. But all the women should be safe, and the medical treatment to them and the assistance to them should be improved. Their nutritional status should be improved. So I always, in a lighter sense, I used to say, when I became the governor here, once I went to Coimbatore, and in the Coimbatore airport I was standing little separately, because I didn't want to disturb the other passengers. Most of them saw and they were wishing me. One girl child asked her mother why everyone is wishing her. Then a mother told, no, she is our governor, so everyone is wishing. The child told, Amma, don't bluff. Mother told, no, she is our governor. Then that child told, Amma, governor will be only old man. How are you telling she is our governor? Then my mother told, no, she is our governor, newly appointed governor. Then immediately that child came near me and wanted a photograph. Then her mother told, you are so, usually you are a shy child, you won't go to near anyone. But immediately when I told that she is our governor, you went near her and you wanted a photograph. Why? That girl child told, when she can become a governor, I can also become a governor. So that is the imprint I want to infuse into even every child. So whatever may be the positive things, as it is said, education, I am at it, health sector, I am at it, and tribal welfare, I am at it. I am not in a position that immediately implement, but I will see, because of my approach, it will be implemented by the government. That is the duty which I can say, I can do. So whatever may be, the approach is very important. See, it's not only the controversies. I always want to be constructive, not controversial. So constructive ideas can help the state, not the controversial ideas. Even though we have controversies, it can be changed into constructive ideas and constructive use. Constructive use can be controversial. Controversial use may be constructive. But finally, it should be constructive to help the people of Telangana. So whether I am... Immediately, I didn't dream in my life I will become a governor, because I was in a political field and then I was working as a president of a particular party and I was working very hard as a women leader. But when this opportunity is given to me, from the first day, I want to do justice to this post. I was a practitioner and I was a very busy practitioner. My husband and myself, both were very busy practitioners. Usually I used to say, when one person went and asked one person, to a political person, please give me a, arrange me a job, sir. That political person told, no, I didn't get a job, so only I came to politics. You are asking me a job. So most of them, I'm not telling everyone, but most of the situation is like that. But my situation was not like that, because I had my gynecologic training and I had my training in a super specialty, which is known as fetal therapy. I went to Canada and then to rectify the anomalies within the womb. I got trained in that, and then I had a very, very roaring practice. In fact, I was attending more than 5 to 6 hospitals. I was a consultant in, I was an assistant professor in a medical college, and I had 2 clinics and a very busy clinic. All this I had. But the passion towards the people service made me, when I became the state president, I didn't want to travel in 2 horses. So to do justice to my post, I resigned all my medical activities and I was only to the political activity. So when I acquired the post of governor, same justification and same justice, I want to do this post. So immediately when I came, you also would have known a political person should not be a governor. So there was a criticism. Then I told, political person can be a governor, but governor should not do politics. That is the that is the real thing which I am following, even though it is difficult for me. Politics is in my blood. But whatever may be the responsibility which is given to me, I know the limitations of it, I know the pride of it, and I know the exact the meaning of what is my duty, my post. And I always, Lord Hyderabad as a medical hub, pharma hub, and I am very thankful that I always, as a first citizen of Telangana, I always said the first vaccine will be from Hyderabad, and definitely the vaccine is from Hyderabad. One of the vaccine, among the 2 vaccines, the Covaxin, I visited the Covaxin to the scientists, I met them, I encouraged them, and I am thankful to our Honorable Prime Minister who he also visited Covaxin, and we are very proud as a doctor, not only as a governor, as a citizen of this country. I am proud because we are not longing to get the vaccine from other countries. We have produced our vaccine and we are getting the vaccine of our country. So true Atmanirbhar, the self-reliant India, I am very proud as a doctor, as a citizen. I am very proud that we are getting the vaccine and I am going to get the vaccine which is produced in my country, not longing to get from other countries. And everyone is asking, you didn't get the vaccine. My husband got it, and I'm also a member of the medical association, but I'm not a first line warrior. I don't want to jump the line, and I will get when the common citizens are getting, definitely I will get. So whatever maybe, I want to be with the people, and I'm for the people, and as it is said, what all things here, I will follow it, and anybody can convey their views so that it will be taken in a much positive way. Whatever may be the negative things, it can be changed into a positive way. So I am really very happy that you all came here, and it's not only a release of book, it's a friendly introduction with each one of us. So I am really very happy. When I became the governor, one of the press person from Tamil Nadu asked, in this age you have become a governor, are you an extraordinary person? I used to tell, no, I am very, very ordinary person who, like other women, they used to tell, when I became the political leader, they used to tell, no, you should be very confined, and you should be wear only cotton saris, and you should put some kondai, and you should look like a political leader. I used to tell, no, I am one among the women. I was one among the sisters of Tamil Nadu, and now I am one among the sisters of Telangana. I like sisters of Telangana, the way they traditionally dress, and I am one among them. So when they ask, are you an extraordinary person to get this post? I always say, no, I am very, very ordinary person, but doing things extraordinarily. So I, with commitment, with conscious of my duty, and always with the people. When I was working as a doctor also, I at that time, ultrasound was a new specialty. Only few centers were practicing ultrasound, few doctors were practicing ultrasound, but I had my training, and one of the pioneers of ultrasound myself, and in my clinic, for 100 rupees for government hospital patients, I did for 100 rupees. That 100 rupees also for current and the printing paper only. At that time, they were charging 2,000 rupees for ultrasound. So always my life is for the people, and even I love the people of Telangana, and I am for the people of Telangana, and whatever the duty given to me, I will do for the sake of the people. I really thank you very much, and I'm always press people are always a friendly people. In Tamil Nadu, I manage the press, and I give interviews. When I go to Tamil Nadu, they used to say, when I am in Chennai, I will give interview. Then I go to Madurai, I will give them interview. Then I pass Dindukal, I will give them interview. Then they used to tell, then why, how you get the message and how can you manage? I used to tell, it is not for myself. The media friends taking the camera in their shoulder, they are in the sun expecting any political leader, whether they will give any message to them. So my message will be always very clear, crystal clear, and very positive. And I want to give some message to the media friends who are toiling in the sun, taking the camera. And it's not the press people from Chennai is different, from Madurai is different, and from Tindukal, the peripheral media friends will be expecting something. So I am always a media friendly person. And I think that a good politician and good media can achieve great results to help the people, and that is my opinion. And I really thank you all for your presence and your very good speech and your points well taken, and I'm really very happy. And my duty as a governor will be for the people and for the people. Thank you so much. And I thank the officers of Telangana, our Raj Bhavan, during the pandemic period. It was not just like Raj Bhavan. It was like a very busy office. Whatever the Twitter message we received, whatever the message we received to help the people, whether they are strangled somewhere, whether they stranded somewhere, whether they had some problem, 24 hours we were working. 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock, we received a message. When they wanted treatment, when they wanted blood donation, when they wanted plasma, and even as a chairman of Red Cross, we have created an app, and more than 18 lakh members we have enrolled. And then we have created an app for blood donation, and we motivated plasma donation. And Raj Bhavan worked really very intensively to help the people during the pandemic period. For that, I thank all the Rajbhavan staff too. Thank you so much.